Welcome back to Let's Play Torment, Tides of Numenera, Blind. I'm the RPG chick. We are in the Sticha Lair. And I want to try to avoid fighting the Sticha. I want to negotiate with them, find a good, you know, what do you call it? A good solution for everybody. Goes back to Underbelly. But we will see what will become of everything. Warm sinews of light lace the wall, spiraling into the base of a hollow statue. It gleams in the same color as the glowing strands. Faint scratches along the base, about the size of a Sticha's claw, suggest they hit the statue while tunneling and could not extract it. Now, we might also find why they are tunneling so much. They're looking for something, apparently. Round tubes with apertures of varying sizes connect to a central drum. A soft breeze from the newly dug burrow behind you hums over the openings. The gnarled metallic veins running through the rocky walls deaden a noise from the surface. It is unlikely to be heard outside this room. Blow into one of the apertures? Your stomach flips as a wave of vibrating air buffets you for a fraction of a second. Golden light flows up from the seams into the statue, forming a looping pattern in the center of the drum. As the rumbling continues, energy coruscates along the veins in the rock running into the device. After a moment, the sound gutters and dies away, but the wispy tracings of the pattern continue to glow on the surface. It is approximately the size of a human hand, though the shape is more like a dozen tentacles. Place your hand on the light tracings.
My studies have borne fruit.
Okay, good. We leveled up, I guess? Or someone did? It's all like calistige. These are things that I would not normally do. Weird thing, blow into it, touch it, bang it, yeah. The same sound you heard before rattles your gut. It sputters but remains on, the acoustics having deteriorated over the millennia. Though the sound is intermittent, there's something fascinating about it that forces you to pay attention. You easily tear your focus away, but the effect might be stronger if the statue was fully intact, especially on a creature with non-human psychology. I was going to say physiology. Non-human psychology. Tiber chuckles. That thing reminds me of a lass I once saw playing a flute in AN. Had a pack of gents stumbling after her, downright captivated. Might have been her music, might have been that she didn't have a single stitch on. Still, I remember her smile the most. Let's get it? Sticha? He.
Yes, now.
The soft, hypnotic vibrations continue to resonate from the statue. It's too subtle to be felt from more than a few meters away. Before the statue is damaged, the sounds are probably audible over a wider area. Reach inside the nearest opening. Yeah, something I don't think... Oh, cool, we got an encephalic rush. Two of them, actually, and 10 shins. Just inside the tube, you feel a piece of loose material. It pulls free with a light tug. Whatever technology this statue represents has been worn away by digging in time, but the fragments may still be useful to you. Cool.
Fine.
So, encephalic rash, you got 2. Yeah, heals 3 points of intellect. Cool. So we are like... Yeah, getting our little buff consumables getting up here. So what does it say about something that's... Yeah, before the statue is damaged, the sounds are probably audible over a wider area. Okay. So we can also touch this, and we can touch that.
Yes, now.
Smooth gray tendrils snake in and out of the rock along this wall, eventually growing out to cover the nearby doorway. Though metallic in texture, the material has grown like a vine or fungus. The individual strands are hard, but warm to the touch. An inky black tendril with sparks darting from its tip extends from the blossoming, tightly bound creepers. You might be able to pull it free from the vine. Lore natural and quick fingers. Try to find the grain of the vine and pull against it. I know I used too many points up. Done. Mycometal vine fragment. Running a finger along the tendril, you feel a slight striation that indicates the grain of the vine. You slip a hand around it and pull directly against the weft. It comes cleanly free. The other strands loosen and separate as you move the fragment by them, then wind back together. Cool. So what is this thing? It's an oddity. Huh. This is a fragment of the organic metal vine you found growing in the Stitch's lair. It shows some unusual magnetic properties. Now we could sell this stuff for money, but these oddities, but I don't want to, because I'm like, we might find some situation we could use one of them. Unexpectedly, you know?
All right.
Without the fragment that repelled the others, the vine has wound itself back together. Okay.
On it.
So I guess we open this thing. Stitcha. I don't want to fight you.
Huh. Let's not tangle with the Sticha if we don't have to.
Sticha? I don't want to tangle with the Sticha. Infiltrate the Sticha lair to steal their eggs or discover the tunnel to the Changing God's Sanctuary. Distract the Sticha using the musical statues. 3 egg clusters remaining. In its dilapidated state, this statue cannot emit enough sound to captivate the Sticha. All this time I've been calling him Sticha. What's this? Oh, I closed it. I didn't want to close it. I need to interact with that thing.
I am the very soul of action.
Don't want to fight him. Babish.
In an instant.
Oh. Juvenile. Are they setting up like force fields or something? Can we zoom out so I can see everything? I don't know where I am in relation to all this. Statue emits a low hum that tugs lightly at your mind, trying to draw your attention. The Sticha cannot seem to resist it as you can. I have to be the last cast off, I think, to do it. I guess that one's already working then.
On it.
I'm not going to destroy it. I just want to look at it. A mound of chitinous plates bulges with cloudy amniotic fluid. In the center, a cluster of leathery shelled eggs the size of a fist lie intertwined, coursing with electricity. Antennae protrude near one end and calcified joints curve inward near the other. The nest shares many features with the other Sticha, but the anatomy has shifted and expanded to protect its gestating embryos. Now, if we spare these things, that would be an awesome role-playing, you know, opportunity that I hope the game will reflect. As you approach this cluster, the mortared limbs creak and shake a few millimeters. The smells of dust and fungus seep into your nose. At a level almost below hearing, clicks and rumbles quiver from deep within the mass. An invisible force tugs on the metal objects in your possession as you come close. It is not strong, but it is insistent. Lore and mystical. Something hidden in the nest seems to be exerting a magnetic attraction. It doesn't feel dangerous, at least not yet. Alright. I'm not going to smash. I'm not going to puncture. Let's examine. This creature was once a Stychus like the others in its lair. Clearly it settled into this position and began to expand, creating a space for the egg cluster. Whether the cluster grew inside this creature or the other Sticha implanted the eggs, there is no way to know. Leave it to Loon. Well, we need to find our way. If we're not going to destroy these, then we're not going to destroy them. Either way, we need to find our way to the lair. So I guess we don't have to activate these things. Captivated. It's doing some kind of magnetic field or something. Yeah. Interact.
I'm ready. I'm always.
Did I do it? Did I interact? Because it didn't show me anything here. See, this says this has the interact sign, but it says examine. And this, same. Does that mean they won't attack? Should I stay where I am? Or move? Well, I could either leave the way I came or go this way. And if it attacks me, just like a bunch of trained lacks, they aren't paying any attention with that music going. Okay. Spotted. Too far away. I guess we should have used hide as well. Nope, didn't work.
Fine.
Yeah, I would love to interact with this thing and accept. Nope. Spotted means she stops. Keep going. Captivated. Click, click. So I guess next we mess with this thing. See, I don't know if we're supposed to be going down this way. How long do they be captivated for? I kind of want to get us all together again, and then we'll ring this next one. Of course, I can't. Yeah, that's the problem.
Yes.
Now, if they start attacking, can I break them off with that? Captivated. I don't know what it's doing. Definitely looks like some metallic, like magnetic thing. Like a magnetic field. And all the little metallic particles are moving away. That one had a big ring. Here's the big guy. Here's the adult. So how long does this last? I wonder if we'll get an idea of... We can go through there. We can ring this. We can ring that.
Here I come.
Huh. Do we have the right person to do this? This device is larger and more pristine than the other statue you found in these tunnels. Two rounded drums are driven deep into the stone floor. Traces of light swirl in dizzying patterns across their surfaces, knotting in and around each other in tight gyres. These glowing threads are similar to the ones on the other statues you've seen, but much more complex. An almost inaudible hum permeates the air around the machine. Okay, I'm guessing that even though he's doing it, we're using my lore machinery or lore mystical. Manipulate the light patterns with your fingers, or try to strike the drums to produce a harmonic sound. Strike the drums to produce a harmonic sound. Success! You bring open palms down on the two drums simultaneously, and gonging resonates through you. A burst of golden light erupts from the machine. Well, it's kind of fitting, it's Aratus, right? For a fraction of a second, your mind is wiped clean, stunned. The Sticha are unlikely to recover so quickly. Cool! Okay, I do want to take a quick peek at what's down here. If anything. To buried crossroads. Okay. I do want to take a... I'm going to leave her there. I want to see if there's anything else to find around here. Stunned for 2 rounds. Captivated and stunned. That one's not stunned, but is captivated. I don't think I can cross this. I don't think I can step there. We have another thing we can interact with. If things go south. Oh, we got loot. Grab that loot. Oh, acid. Crap. Ooh, we've got odd gloves. And 35 shins. I want to look at these. These six-fingered gloves are completely and utterly achromatic. Their singular lack of color is nearly hypnotic. Interesting. Oh, and we can level up her. But not yet. What's this? Who are we on? We're on last... Oh, I'm gonna keep her there. Right? She's here. Yeah. End turn. LSDs? This thing is open, right? Oh, that's another egg thing. Yeah, I think I've seen all that there is to see. I'm pretty sure the other eggs are going to be just the same. We'll have Kalishtis start moving down.
In an instant.
In an instant. This is pretty awesome. I'm enjoying this. I can't really go that way. How much did he get hurt by the acid? Not much. I just want to see if there's anything down this way.
Something to do.
No, we're not unraveling anything. Okay. Let's get back.
Action. Here I come.
We didn't get hurt again this time. Good. Cool though, finding places, going places, achieving things.
Yes.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Yes, child.
Can I leave the area? I hope so. They're all captivated still, I hope. Eritus has to catch up.
You want a job done right?
Then run this way. Okay, can we exit? Gladly.
My studies have borne fruit.
Nice. Yeah, we need to level her up. Ooh, is this... Oh my dear, this place was your creator's. We must search it and search it exhaustively. First, I would just like to get to know you. can increase her trans-dimensional onslaught. I kind of like that. Ooh, was that her? What'd she say? That's cool. Whoa, guys. Stuff. Huh. Want to keep going, but we've just made it to this new area. I know this is a shorter episode, but hey, that's the entire Sticha Lair. So that makes a good round episode there. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode when we explore the buried crossroads. Ooh, awesome. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.